I've actually had a couple of requests from people that have bought Robertas and haven't actually learnt to spin yet. So hopefully I can actually give them a little bit of a hand. Now what I'm going to show you today is the way I do things. Different people do different things. It just all depends. But I'll show you the way I do it. First of all, what we're going to do today, in the last video I showed the setup of the Roberta. Today we're going to organize the bobbin and start to spin. So first of all, I've got a bit of cotton here, nice long length. I've actually tied a knot as a loop here. All right, so all I'm going to do now, once you've tied a knot, I'm just going to bring that through so I have another loop. Okay, and with this loop I can adjust it up and down, and all I'm going to do is I'm going to pop that onto the bobbin there like that and pull it tight. Okay, so on there and pull it tight. This just gives us a leader. Sometimes I have found that the leader will actually go round a number of times when I don't want it to. So you can, if you want, bring your yarn up over the top and another one down the bottom and pull it through. Right, and that just gives you two loops on there, and it's less likely when you're first starting off for it to keep spinning around. I have had that even after years of spinning. I've done that before where I've done a quick loop and all of a sudden it's just spinning and spinning and spinning and doesn't want to take out. Now, the next thing we do is we're going to put our bobbin on, right? So now I already put oil on here. I just put a drop before. If it's a brand new bobbin, I usually suggest, say, 2 drops of oil. You will find after a while, you do not have to add oil all the time. I have actually found that adding oil all the time, I've ended up with a squeaky bobbin. I don't know why, because when you think oil, it shouldn't squeak, but you know, it does. Now we're just going to pop that on. So we're going to pop the orifice through there, just through the front. I'm just going to turn that round. So the orifice through there, and I'll turn my wheel back around. Now I always like to just put my loop over for now while I slot that in, and then now, oh, I can't really see that very good. Here we are. I'll just move it down there. So I've just got my belt there, my rubber belt, and I'm just going to put it around the silver bit down the bottom, and I'm just going to run it up as I turn the bobbin, and I'm holding my finger and turn it over, and it just clicks into place there. So you can just double check that it's around the silver and around the ridge in the bobbin there. Now, the next step, right, we're going to take our yarn. Now, I don't know if I mentioned a moment ago, we actually, it doesn't have to be cotton, it can be wool, it can be anything. It's just so that you have something for the wool that you're going to spin to attach onto. Now, I like my hook to start off at the end and I work my way along the bobbin. So I've just moved that up, pushed the rubber band up, and I'm just going to put that yarn over the first hook and then the second hook. Then I'm going to take my hook from the side of the machine where I keep it stored. Right, I'm just going to pop it through the orifice, hook it onto the yarn, and pull it through. So we've got that there now. Just leave that oil over there. Okay, so now, as you can see, we've got it attached, our leader attached to the bobbin through the hooks and threaded through the orifice. Now I like to actually, and of course, I've got my trusty pause control down on the floor where my foot can reach it easily. Now what I like to do is I actually like to go through, I like to check when I'm going to spin the first yarn that the first switch is on forward, my twist control, my twist rate is on 9 o'clock. Let's hold that up. Okay, so we've got switch on forward, this on about 9 o'clock, and this one for the moment is off, but I'll switch that one on in a moment. But when I switch it on, I'll actually keep my foot on the pause control. Now the other thing I need to do is just to add my Irish tension. Now you can actually hook this around twice, which I used to do, but one day I actually hooked my finger on it and I was not very impressed. So I'll just pop that on there and I'm just going to tighten that a little bit. I don't like mine too tight. As I said, again, it's personal preference, right? Everyone spins differently. Everyone prepares their wool differently. Once you've got the basics of learning to spin, and you learn what suits you, you learn how to hold your hands, you learn whether you do a long draw or a short draw. It's really just practice. Now, I am going to switch that on. I've actually cut this leader a little bit long, so I'm just going to let it take up there a little bit. Now, there is actually a number of ways to do this as well. I have seen a number of people actually tie another little loop in the end of the yarn, and then when they start off, they actually hook it through. Today I'm just going to show you a way that I've been doing for many years. I do like to use this a certain length, especially while I'm doing alpaca. I find that alpaca actually tends to come apart fairly easy. I think this is sort of because it doesn't actually have the lanolin that, say, sheep's wool does. I have been told some people actually do use a water-soluble spray that they use on the alpaca. I haven't tried it. I may try it in the future just to see. But for today, I'm just going to spin two lots. Now, this is, as you can see, raw alpaca. I haven't actually washed this. It's straight from the fleece, and I usually just like to brush the tips out a little bit. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to add my yarn onto the leader and I'm just going to let it twist. Now I probably tend to over twist a little bit at the start while it's going onto the cotton yarn because I like it to hold. I'm just letting that roll in. So I'm just pulling that a little bit at a time. I personally find when I've tried to do more to start with, I tend to find my alpaca keeps coming undone, and that can be extremely frustrating. So that's, as you can see, that's on the bobbin there. That's actually taken. Now, so what you need to do, as I said, some people will long draw. It also depends on how you've prepared your yarn. What you want to do, I've just fluffed this one up, and all you want to do, look, to start off with, this is probably the easier way that I would probably suggest. Others might say differently, but what you want to do is you want to draft this as you go, right? And one thing I will say with spinning, I don't know how other spinners think about this, but I know most spinners, when they first start off, they want the yarn as even as possible. And I always say, don't worry if it's not totally even. You know, this is yarn that's original, it's hand spun, it's not factory spun. It doesn't have to be perfect. And I find most spinners that have spun to start off with, actually later on, actually have a lot more trouble trying to add lumps and bumps and bobbles and that in there. So You know, when you're starting to spin, don't think it has to be perfect. If you've got a thick bit there and a thin bit there, that's fine. Okay, so I've just pulled that off because I felt that was a bit loose, so I'm just going to draft my wool back in. I've got a nice tail here, so that will actually help me to attach this wool back in. So, right, and it doesn't matter whether you go inch by inch to start off with. You know, don't be in a rush. Don't be in a rush at all. Right. Okay, so just draft it out as you go. If you get a little lump in your wool that you don't want, and you've got a pause control, just stop for a moment. If you don't have a pause control, you'll need to switch the switch off. But, or the other way with a Roberta, you can actually pull hard on it if you're using the Irish brake, and this will actually stop spinning while you do that. As I said, I just prefer the pause control. Okay, so just, and I've actually got, this fleece is a beautiful fleece, but it does have a lot of secondary cuts in it. So, okay, so just draft it out. As you get a little bit quicker and a little bit more confident, you'll actually find that you can actually draft your wool with one hand and hold it with the other. Now, there's no specific way about holding your yarn. Alright, and I'll probably actually, I might need to do another video later with the large camera holder to see if I can get it pointing down. So I'm trying to do it on a bit of an angle, but I don't really think you can actually see that. Okay, so I've just pulled that off. And I'm just going to add this back in now. So, just, alright, a little bit of fluff there. It's still attached. Let it spin. Alright. And just pull. Okay. Now, I don't know if that sideways is helping. Right. So just pull your wool out. Right. As you become more confident, you can actually draw it out longer and let the twist run up. Right. Okay. So. Alright. Now, I'm just going to take that bit off. That was just straight. A little bit of alpaca straight done. Now, I've got a bit here that I've already semi-drafted out. This was just what I did on my blending board. I haven't blended any colours in it. It's just, again, raw alpaca. And I'm just going to do the same there. It's the same if you're using carded fleece. Or rovings, actually. Rovings are thinner. And it's just a matter of drafting it out. I can probably spin a little bit quicker here. As I said, I've got a little bit, few shortcuts. Sometimes I'll pick them out. It just depends on what I'm doing with the yarn. It depends on whether I'm going to use it for weaving or for knitting. So all you do, just keep pulling it out and just pulling it in, right? Okay, so pull out, right? So just keep drafting, and as you move your fingers up the yarn like that, the twist will run up. Alright, so pull it out. Alright, it's up to you. Okay, it's just really the same rhythm. The more you spin, the easier it will become. You will get to learn how to use your hands. Sometimes I actually don't even hold my fingers much like that. I'll just pull out yarn like this. Just be careful when you're doing that, that it doesn't travel up too much, right? But as I said, look, starting little bit by little bit, you can, if you've got that pause control, you can put your foot on that pause control every few seconds if you want. Look, I've got it on the pause control. I can actually, if I'm, say, overspinning, which I'm not at this point, right, so you could actually bring your yarn in Right, now you can actually get this prepared. At the moment you can see the flyer's not spinning, so you can bring this up a little bit so it's ready. Take your foot off the pause control and let it spin. Right, don't get frustrated if your yarn comes apart. It's just as easy to bring it back from the flyer, thread it through and catch some more. The main thing is, don't give up. You will actually find it actually starts to become fun, especially when you actually look at it and you think, oh, I've created some wool. You can get an idea of the ply by putting it together, letting it twist back. I'm probably doing this a lot thinner than you will be at the start. You might like to do a nice chunky yarn, like, let's see, we'll join this. You might like to do something like a nice chunky style yarn. And I'm actually having trouble doing a chunky one. It's just, it's winter here at the moment. So I've actually been so busy doing shawls that I've actually needed to do thin wool. But, as I said, don't worry if parts are thick and parts are thin. You know, this is, it's creative. It's fun. You know, and don't expect your wool to be perfect. Just have fun with it. If you've got any questions, you know, please feel free to ask. As I said, other people will spin differently, they'll attach their leaders differently, they'll prepare their wool differently. It's one of the wonderful things about being creative and allowing yourself to be creative. It's all about whether you enjoy it or not. So for now, keep on spinning and we'll see you again soon. I hope to have a few spin-ins later in the future, so maybe in the next few months we can actually all do something creative. So in the meantime, take care, keep drafting, and enjoy your spinning. Oh, by the way, one thing I'll mention before I go, you'll see this is filled up here. Every time you want to move it along, just move your band. Move your hook, right, and that will start spinning on the next section. I'll just mention that because I don't want you to just to keep spinning and spinning and spinning, so you end up with this huge section on one area and not on the other. So as you're spinning, you know, when you get a little bit of wool on there, that's me waiting for the man to come with my wood to light my fire. Okay, so as you move along, just every now and then, when it gets big enough, move it back, start spinning again. I like to just do all the little sections along. I'm just using a regular size bobbin at the moment. I like to spin on the regular size bobbins and ply on the jumbos, so that sort of suits me. I have a rough idea how many skeins I need to do a shawl and I go from there. So, as I said, just keep working your way along the bobbin and then do the same going back and just keep going backwards and forwards bit by bit until it fills up. Anyway, for now, it's great to see you and I hope to see you again soon. Happy spinning. Bye.